What's up guys and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. For all those who have been coming back to watch my videos, I'm truly grateful. And if you're new here, this is your first time, do me a favor by clicking the subscribe button so we can go on this motorcycle vlogging journey together. So guys, today I've gone to a beautiful park and I found a quiet place just to relax for a while. And while doing so, I thought I should just bring you up this video to say a few things about why you would want to own a motorcycle, especially in 2021. If you don't already own a motorcycle and you're sitting on the fence trying to decide as to whether to get a motorcycle or not, this might be the video for you. But if you already own one, well, this might also reinforce the reasons why you bought the motorcycle in the first place. So without much ado, let's go and talk about a few things that will urge you or will make you want to buy a motorcycle. The first thing I'd like to talk about is convenience of owning a motorcycle. So motorcycles are very convenient for those who don't know. When you own a motorcycle, commuting to and from work and just going around and doing your daily tasks is quite easy to do and quite straightforward. Unlike a car where you have to stay in traffic for a long time before you get to where you're going, with motorcycles, it's not really the case. I mean, when there's traffic, you can always weave through the traffic. Of course, doing that safely without getting hurt, but that is one of the conveniences that a motorcycle offers. You can always weave through traffic to get to where you're going quicker than if you were driving a car. Because with a car, there's nothing you can do. You just have to stay with the traffic. But with motorcycles, you can always weave through the traffic, taking note of safety precautions so you don't get into trouble. And of course, respecting traffic rules. But what it means is you can always get to where you're going faster. So motorcycles are very convenient. The next thing I'd like to talk about is motorcycles are relatively cheaper to run than a car. Now, this might be controversial depending on the motorcycle you own. So bigger motorcycles with bigger CCs, especially when it's older, you might spend a bit of money here and there changing things and servicing it or maintaining it. But there are many motorcycles out there on the market that are very cheap to run. The one I currently own and run is the 2019 version of the Honda CB500X, and it's very low on fuel and maintenance cost is very low as well. So motorcycles, for the most part, are cheaper to run. For a car, you need a lot more money to fill up your tank, but with a motorcycle, it's not that much. For example, with the 2019 CB500X, the total tank capacity is about 4 something gallons, so it's not that much to fill it up. And when you do and you don't ride like a maniac, which I do sometimes, you can definitely go, depending on how you use it, about a week without refilling. So it actually depends on how you ride and what your distances are. But for the most part, motorcycles are cheaper to run, and so they're gonna save you a lot of money in the long run. I'd like to talk about is the fun part of motorcycle. So yes, when you're riding a motorcycle, you're exposed to the vagaries of the weather. When it's raining, you get beat by the rain. When it's cold, you feel cold. You don't have heating on a motorcycle. Well, new motorcycles have heated grips, heated seats and all that, but your general self is gonna feel colder than if you were in a car. But still, motorcycles are a lot more fun. They give you a lot more freedom, because you can go where you want to go. It's just two wheels and it's narrower than a car, so you can move into tight spaces, take shortcuts and all that. So it gives you that sense of freedom, that sense of control over your movement. So that's one big advantage of having a motorcycle over a car. Motorcycles are also great for going on long trips. So you can go solo or you can go with a pannier, a partner, and it's great. I mean, you can even communicate whilst you're on the go. So if you have a helmet communication gadget that connects to the other helmet, then just like in a car, you can talk to your partner behind you or in front of you, whichever the case might be. You can talk through your helmet while you're riding. And when you get to your rest stop or hotels and places like that, you don't need to struggle for parking and all that. All you need is, if you have your trip properly set up, you have pannier or top box, you put all your belongings in there. You don't need that much if you're going on a road trip. You take only the things that are necessary for you to use. And so it offers a lot of convenience in terms of long trips as well. And that also means that you can take shortcuts. Depending on the motorcycle you have, if you are on your way and you see a shortcut that's on B roads, if you have an adventure or sort of a mini adventure bike, you can just veer off and take the shortcut. And that's even more fun. Depending on the motorcycle you have, if you have a strictly road bike or a touring bike, this might not be, you have to use the main roads, but if you have an adventure or a mini sort of adventure bike, you can always veer off and have some fun before you get to your destination. The next fun thing about motorcycles is it's quite easy to accessorize a motorcycle. So for most vehicles, they come stock with certain functions, and what you pay for is what you get. And often you can do aftermarket alterations and installations here and there, but the motorcycles have a much wider accessory package that you can add onto your bike. So that also gives you that convenience. So if your bike didn't come with, say, heated grips, you can always install them aftermarket. If they didn't come with the foot pegs that you want, you can always install them aftermarket, exhaust, you name it. So there's a lot of things you can change on your motorcycle to suit your style, whereas in a car it's a bit more difficult. It can be done, but it's a bit more difficult, and there are too many regulations surrounding cars. So in terms of that, it's not that convenient, but on a motorcycle it's very, very convenient. You can always change things on your motorcycle to suit you. So yes, you can add a lot of accessories onto your motorcycle to suit your style of riding and your likes. Next, we'll talk about the convenience of parking a motorcycle. So when you stop anywhere at home or at a commercial place or at work, it's a lot easier to park your motorcycle than a car. Sometimes you go to a place and there aren't enough parking spaces, but with a motorcycle, any little space you find, you can always fit yourself in there and park it. Of course, you have to park properly, but it offers a lot more convenience. What is this worm doing with me? It offers a lot more convenience with regards to parking. So you don't need that much space. You find a corner that doesn't obstruct anybody or anything. You can just park it there properly, lock it up, and off you go. So in terms of parking, it takes little space, it's convenient to park, and it's quicker to park. So guys, these are a few of my opinions on why you would want to choose a motorcycle as your means of transport. If you're on the fence trying to decide whether to get a motorcycle or not, maybe you already have a car and you want to find something more convenient and easy to use, or you're just starting out and you're thinking about getting a motorcycle, well, these tips might help you decide whether or not to get a motorcycle. Of course, the kind of motorcycle you get largely depends on your budget, but do your research, see what fits you best. But I tell you, a motorcycle is a lot more convenient and a lot more fun from my personal experience. So don't wait, make your decision and get your motorcycle today. So that's all for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section if you have any. And if you are new here, once again, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to subscribe to this channel. So, till I see you in the next video, guys, ride legal, ride safe. Peace.